और दूसरा जो ये लोग हैं जो हमारे शहर बनाते हैं, हमारे घर बनाते हैं, हमारी हमारी जिंदगी को संवारते हैं, हमारी जिंदगी का सबसे बड़ा सपोर्ट है। अगर आप सोचिए कि आपके घर में एक दिन मेड ना आए, आपके के पास आपका आपकी कबर्ड्स खराब है, आपके पास कारपेंटर ना आए, आपके घर में आपको प्लास्टर करना है आप वो ना आए, आपको व्हाइट वॉश करना है वो ना आए, आपको आयरन करना है बाहर प्रेस वाला ना हो, इस्त्री वाला ना हो, तो आप सोचिए कि आपकी लाइफ कितनी बदल जाती है। और आपका न्यूज़पेपर वाला ना आए, लेकिन हम लोगों ने क्या किया हुआ, इन सब के जो नाम, एक तो हम इनके नाम नहीं पूछते, हमको इनके नाम नहीं पता होते, दूसरा अगर हमको इनकी जरूरत है तो इनका नाम इस तरह से सेव होते हैं, कार वाला, कार वॉश वाला, न्यूज़पेपर वाला, फिश वाला। तो मेरी जिंदगी में जो सबसे बड़ा बदलाव आया कि अब सबके नाम है, अब जब मैं इनके मोबाइल पे इनके इनसे बात करता हूँ तो मेरे पास सबके नाम, मैंने इनके नाम के साथ इनको सेव किया हुआ है, क्योंकि इस जर्नी से मुझे एक इन सबको एक चेहरा मिला, इन सबको एक, और वही मैं देख रहा हूँ कि जितने लोगों ने भी ये फिल्म देखी तो सबकी जिंदगी में जो बदलाव मेरी जिंदगी में आया इस यात्रा से, इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री को देखने के बाद सबकी जिंदगी में यही बदलाव आया कि अब वो कह रहे हैं कि अब हमारे लिए इनके मन में प्यार और इज्जत बहुत बढ़ गई है, और अब ये सब हमारे लिए गुमनाम लोग नहीं है जिनको हम कभी तरजीह नहीं देते थे। इट वाज ऑलमोस्ट आफ्टर 30, इट वाज 32nd डे ऑफ लॉकडाउन, 30 या 32nd डे ऑफ लॉकडाउन, एंड आई रियलाइज दैट यू नो वी काइंड ऑफ अनाउंस लॉकडाउन, बट एट द सेम टाइम आफ्टर 32 डेज वी वर नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड एट ऑल, एंड वी वर And we just ignored these people, especially daily wage laborers. We just ignored them. Initially, they were really, really beaten up at this Ganges, Brajghat. Police were after their life. In fact, police warned them that you can't go ahead. Otherwise, hum aapko Ganga mein duba denge. And after that, when I met them, people were kind of when they used to stop to drink some water at the government hand pump, people, the villagers used to tell them that please don't drink water from our hand pump because you guys are coming from Delhi, Ghaziabad, and that is a hot spot of COVID. So we asked him to, can we get some food, can we get some water? He blatantly refused. He said, no, we can't do. You go 4 kilometers aage jao, wahan pe kuch milega, dharamshala hoga to dekhenge.
So it's been 1 year since the migrant crisis hit India. And since then, we have reported about the issues that the migrants have been facing. They've also tried to cover the crisis as much as possible, but not enough has been done until now. We have with us, of course, the award-winning national filmmaker, Vinod Kapri, who has come up with a documentary titled 1232 Kilometers. It's out on Hotstar, and it is about the migrant crisis in India. He's joining us right now. Mr. Kapri, thanks very much for your time. I want to first...
Thank you, Shruta.
I want to first begin by asking you, what made you follow these 7 migrant workers that you have followed in your documentary? What prompted you to stay with them to understand their journey in India? And this was during the peak of the lockdown.
Yeah, actually, Shweta, what happened when this lockdown was announced on the 24th of night, it was only a 4-hour notice for everybody. So next day, there were thousands of people out there on the roads, and they were, I saw a few videos, few pictures, a few news clips on social media, and I was really, really very disturbed. And then I saw one clip in which a 14 or 15 year old boy was literally, he was crying that he has no food, he's out of ration and he's out of money. So I was very curious at that point of time, Shweta, to understand that why these people are leaving. Why it's hardly 24 hours and these people are on the roads. So I was very curious to understand that what are the circumstances which has forced them to leave their home, and just they are taking such extreme decisions. And at the same time, I was also very curious to understand. And after 2-3 days, on 25th, 26th of March, 27th of March, we got to know there were many news reports, especially on social media. Mainstream media was not covering it at all. but mainstream media was only focused on Tablighi Jamaat and all. But the social media, there were many more video clippings and news reports which was indicating that people are traveling. They are going on the foot, by foot, for 800 kilometers, 900 kilometers, and at the same time they are using their bicycle. They are buying a second-hand bicycle and they are traveling for 1200, 1500 kilometers. So at that point of time, Shweta, I was really, really curious to understand that what is their journeys like? What kind of difficulties they are going to face? Who is going to feed them? How they are going to survive? I was aware that it is a complete national lockdown. All shops are closed. All hotels, dhabas, everything is closed. So who is going to help them? So it was kind of I was very and I thought that I should be part of their journey, one of their journey, and I should understand that, and I should document that journey, that what is this journey is like.
And it was a journey of hardship, Mr. Kapri. It wasn't an easy journey, as you rightly pointed out. There was a complete lockdown in the country. Shops were closed, you know, even emergency services were not easily available. And these people, these migrant laborers, who we really don't treat as very important as a part of an internal economy that we are in, and we'll come to that in a bit. But these people were out, they were stranded. What was it that your first experience with them, when you started moving out with them, what was the experience like?
You know, Shweta, this lockdown was announced on 24th of March, and on 12th of April, it was 12th of April when I saw there was a small Twitter post, and somebody tagged me, and in which it was mentioned that there are 30 laborers in Luni, Ghaziabad, and they are out of their ration from last 2 weeks, two to 3 days, and there was one phone number also. So I called up on that particular number, and it was Ritesh who is part of the film, who is part of the documentary. So I had a conversation with him, and he told me his ordeal, and he told me that they are completely out of ration. So I immediately tweeted and I asked him, can you just make one video if you have a video phone, or if you have WhatsApp, can you just WhatsApp me so that I can escalate that issue? So he immediately sent me one video, which was, I tweeted that. We got an assurance also from District Magistrate Ghaziabad and Police Helpline Ghaziabad that the help should be reaching to them in a couple of hours. But in the evening, after 6-7 hours, he again called me and he said, sir, koi help nahi aaya, koi madad nahi aaya, and we are out of ration. So then I asked for his account number and I deposited that some amount. And for 3-4 days, they were fine enough. After 3-4 days, it was 16th or 17th of April, again he called and he said, sir, again, we are out of ration. So again, we tried to help them. And for 3-4 days, again, he was quiet. On 23rd of April, he called me again and he said, sir, we are not beggars, we are laborers, and we have some dignity. So we don't need your help. We don't need your monetary help. We just need, either you provide us some job, or can you make some arrangements so that we can go to our villages, our hometowns. So I told him categorically that Ritesh, this is not possible because lockdown is imposed, so you can't move out, and at the same time you can't everything is shut, so you can't I can't promise you any job right now. So what I can do, I can help you. But after 3-4 days, it was 27th of April when I got to know that these people have already moved. And they are 60 kilometers away from Delhi, which is at a place called Hapur. So then I realized, Shweta, that it was almost 32nd day of lockdown, and I realized that we kind of announced lockdown, but at the same time, after 32 days, we were not prepared at all, and we just ignored these people, especially daily wage laborers. We just ignored them. And at that point of time, when Ritesh told me that they have already started their journey, so I thought that you know, this is the right time that I should be part of their journey. So, and when I met them, so they were telling me that from last 2 days, they were hungry. So I asked him that you are in touch with me. So why didn't you call me? So he said, sir, we are not beggar. We live like, you know, we want to do hard work and then earn money. So it's whether government is helping us or not. So now we have decided that marenge to raaste mein marenge, yahan to hum sarkar ke bharose nahi rahenge. So this is what the feeling was when I met them for the first time.
Right. So it's 32 days since the lockdown. They are still stranded. They decide to move and you decide to start catching their journey or the glimpses of their journey. What is it that you discovered, Mr. Kapri? While you were documenting their journey, what is it that you discovered that perhaps us as people who were only sitting at home, who only got to see a few video clips here and there, we did not know?
So, you know, it was a journey of 7 days and seven nights. And, you know, I would say that it was a journey of, I would say that in one line, it was a journey of a life. And, you know, when it was a journey of good, bad, and unexpected. So, and this is what life is all about. You know, there are some, we meet very good people, and at the same time we meet very bad people, and at the same time there are some events which are so unexpected. So initially they were really, really beaten up at this Ganges Braj Ghat. Police were after their life. In fact, police warned them that, you know, you can't go ahead, otherwise hum aapko ganga mein duba denge. You have a choice, either you guys go back to your Ghaziabad or there's a Ganges there, yahan pe ganga hai, hum usme aapko duba denge. So these guys are very firm and adamant that they want to go. So they asked for some help from local boatmen. Initially they refused because police were beating them up also. So they refused, but eventually these guys decided that they will cross Ganges because they thought that they are good swimmers, because the area in which they live is a place called Sehersa, and every day the floods it is affected by flood. So they thought they will swim across the Ganges, but eventually the boatmen saw that, and they asked them that Ritesh, Ram Babu, why are you risking your lives? So okay, we will help you. So and after that, they were, for one day they were completely traumatized after the horrible experience of that night when police beat them. And you know, after that, you know, when I met them, people were kind of, you know, when they used to stop to drink some water at the government hand pump, people, the villagers used to tell them that please don't drink water from our hand pump, because you guys are coming from Delhi, Ghaziabad, and that is a hot spot of COVID. So please bear with us and don't touch our hand pump, because otherwise we will also get infected by a virus. And it happened with one or two dhabas also, when we asked for help. In fact, we were also part of that journey. So when we asked for help, the dhawa guy completely refused. He said, no, we can't, it was his word, it is not my headache, we are not allowing any outsider. So we asked him to, can we get some food, can we get some water? He blatantly refused. He said, no, we can't do, you go 4 kilometers aage jao, wahan pe kuch milega, dharamshala hoga to dekhenge. So there were these kind of people, but at the same time, yeah.
Mr. Kapri, how did you manage water, food? If people were not ready to cooperate, how were you able to sustain all this way?
So, you know, the best thing which was available was bananas and apples and some fruits. The fruits were available, and at some places, water was also available. Cold drink was also available, but the cold drink was with expired dates, at least 3 to 4 months with expiry dates. So, but we took that because, you know, we thought that pata nahi aage kuch milega ki nahi milega, jo mil raha hai usko le lete. So we were aware that it was really it is really going to be tough for them also, and at the same time tough for us also. But at the same time, since I had a journalistic background, so I asked many people, local people, to help us over the phone. And it was third day when one of our laborer, Mukesh, he collapsed and he was unconscious for at least 10 to 15 minutes. It was around 11 p.m. in the night. And we all were hungry from at least 7 to 8 hours. So at that point of time, I called up one of the local stringer at the place called Hardoi, and we were at near Shahabad. So I narrated him the incident that this is what we are doing, and I'm with seven laborers and all of them are hungry. So he told me that there was langar during daytime, and maybe some puris and some aloo sabji is left. So I'll try to get that for you. So we asked these laborers to just stay there for 1 hour, 90 minutes. We will be driving our car and we'll get some food. And when we reached Shahabad, we got some 40 to 50 puris. And it was good enough for 9 people, at least.
It's a strange predicament, Mr. Kapri. You can't be where you are. Ab jahan hain, ab wahan nahi reh sakte kyunki naukri nahi hai, khana nahi hai. Ab jahan jana chahte hain, wahan aapko nahi jaane diya ja raha hai. Kyunki sarkar support nahi kar rahi, local lights support nahi kar rahe, police support nahi kar rahi. इस पूरी जर्नी में आपकी सबसे बड़ी सीख क्या थी?
जो इस जर्नी से सबसे बड़ी सीख मिली श्वेता, वो ये कि हमने अपने जो जिंदगी है उसको हमने बहुत फैला दिया है, बहुत विस्तार दे दिया है. हमको हर चीज चाहिए. हम लोग किसी रेस्टोरेंट में जाते हैं तो हम लोग चार पांच तरह की चीजें ऑर्डर कर देते हैं कि इसको भी टेस्ट कर लेंगे, इसको भी टेस्ट कर लेंगे, उसको भी टेस्ट कर लेंगे. और बाद में हम जब उठते हैं तो उसमें से कई सारी जो हमारी ऑर्डर की होती है उसमें काफी कुछ बचा होता है. तो एक तो जिंदगी में अब ये बदल गया कि जितना जरूरत है उतना ही लेना चाहिए. और दूसरा, जो ये लोग हैं जो हमारे शहर बनाते हैं, हमारे घर बनाते हैं, हमारी हमारी जिंदगी को संवारते हैं, हमारी जिंदगी का सबसे बड़ा सपोर्ट है. अगर आप सोचिए कि आपके घर में एक दिन मेड ना आए, आपके के पास आपका आपकी कबर्ड्स खराब है, आपके पास कारपेंटर ना आए, आपके घर में आपको प्लास्टर करना है आप वो ना आए, आपको व्हाइट वॉश करना है वो ना आए, आपको आयरन करना है बाहर प्रेस वाला ना हो, इस्त्री वाला ना हो, तो आप सोचिए कि आपकी लाइफ कितनी बदल जाती है. और आपका न्यूज़पेपर वाला ना आए. लेकिन हम लोगों ने क्या किया हुआ, इन सब के जो नाम, एक तो हम इनके नाम नहीं पूछते, हमको इनके नाम नहीं पता होते. दूसरा, अगर हमको इनकी जरूरत है तो इनका नाम इस तरह से सेव होते हैं, कार वाला, कार वॉश वाला, न्यूज़पेपर वाला, फिश वाला. तो मेरी जिंदगी में जो सबसे बड़ा बदलाव आया कि अब सबके नाम है. अब जब मैं इनके मोबाइल पे इनके इनसे बात करता हूँ तो मेरे पास सबके नाम, मैंने इनके नाम के साथ इनको सेव किया हुआ है. क्योंकि इस जर्नी से मुझे एक इन सबको एक चेहरा मिला, इन सबको एक. और वही मैं देख रहा हूँ कि जितने लोगों ने भी ये फिल्म देखी तो सबकी जिंदगी में जो बदलाव मेरी जिंदगी में आया इस यात्रा से, इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री को देखने के बाद सबकी जिंदगी में यही बदलाव आया कि अब वो कह रहे हैं कि अब हमारे लिए इनके मन में प्यार और इज्जत बहुत बढ़ गई है और अब ये सब हमारे लिए गुमनाम लोग नहीं है जिनको हम कभी तरजीह नहीं देते थे.
क्या आप अभी भी कांटेक्ट में हैं मिस्टर कापरे इन सातों माइग्रेंट लेबर्स के साथ? क्या अभी भी कांटेक्ट में हैं? इस वक्त क्या हाल है, इस वक्त क्या स्थिति है?
मैं सातों लोगों के कांटेक्ट में हूं. अभी अब दिवाली पे लोग घर पे बुलाया था इन लोगों को, सभी को. तो हम लोगों ने दिवाली साथ में मनाई. रात को लोगों ने डिनर पे आए थे. और अभी होली से एक दिन पहले, क्योंकि होली से 3 दिन पहले फिल्म रिलीज हुई थी, तो इन लोगों की सबकी बड़ी इच्छा थी कि ये लोग फिल्म देखें. तो सबको घर पे बुलाया था, तो सभी सातों के सातों आए थे और घर पे इन्होंने फिल्म देखी और हम लोगों ने होली भी खेली थोड़ी बहुत. और सभी लोग अब एक तरह से all of them are part of my life, basically they are part of family. अब ये परिवार का हिस्सा है और हर चीज जिंदगी में अच्छी बुरी कुछ भी इनके साथ होता है. किसी का बच्चा हो गया, किसी घर में मुंडन है, किसी घर में शादी है, तो उसकी ये लोग अपनी तस्वीरें WhatsApp पे मुझे भेजते हैं, हर चीज की उस शेयर करते हैं. कोई प्रॉब्लम है उसके बारे में बताते हैं, कोई खुशी की बात है उसके बारे में बताते हैं. वापस गाजियाबाद आ चुके हैं सभी लोग, जिस जगह पे रहते थे अब वहीं रहते हैं, फिर से वही काम करने लगे हैं. हम लोगों ने इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री से जितना हम लोगों को मिला उसकी हमने जो भी एक उचित रकम हो सकती थी, मदद हो सकती थी, वो इन तक पहुंचाई। इनकी जिंदगी में थोड़ा बहुत फर्क आया है तो उसकी हमें खुशी है। इसके अलावा मैं हिंदी और इंग्लिश में मेरी बुक भी आ रही है इसी इसी जर्नी पर, तो हमने उसको डिसाइड किया कि उसकी सारी रॉयल्टी हम इन्हीं सातों मजदूरों तक पहुंचाएंगे। तो मेरे लिए मतलब एक अब ये वो यात्रा मतलब एक फिल्म और डॉक्यूमेंट्री तक खत्म नहीं हो गई, अब ये पूरी यात्रा जीवन तक की यात्रा है, जब तक सांस है तब तक ये लोग जिंदगी का हिस्सा है।
कापरी जी पत्रकार भी रह चुके हैं आप, इससे एक तरीके से हमें ये भी समझ में आया कि सरकार के अपने आप विंग्स में राइट और लेफ्ट हैंड को नहीं पता कि राइट हैंड क्या कर रहा है, राइट हैंड को नहीं पता लेफ्ट हैंड क्या कर रहा है। कई रिपोर्ट्स में अभी सामने आ रहा है कि जब अनाउंसमेंट हुआ लॉकडाउन का तो डिपार्टमेंट्स अवेयर नहीं थे, तो वो किसी तरीके का प्रबंधन नहीं कर पाए। एक मैसिव जो डिसफंक्शनल हमारा इस वक्त सिस्टम है, इससे उसमें भी काफी हाईलाइट होता है, वो डिसफंक्शनल सिस्टम काफी हाईलाइट होता है।
रात को 8 बजे जिस व्यक्ति को अनाउंस करना था सिर्फ उन्हीं को पता था कि आज रात 8 बजे से लॉकडाउन है। मतलब ये सिर्फ मजाक नहीं है, बहुत ही गंभीर बात, बहुत ही गंभीर बात है। और ये बहुत ही गंभीर इसलिए है क्योंकि जब इस तरह के फैसले होते हैं तो मुझे आज तक श्वेता इस बात पे यकीन नहीं होता कि जब इस तरह के फैसले होते हैं, ये बहुत जरूरी फैसला इसमें कोई शक नहीं, लेकिन वो करोड़ों लोग जो दिहाड़ी मजदूर हैं, जो दिन में 280 रुपया, 310 रुपया, 340 रुपया और 400 रुपया कमाते हैं, और जब वो दिन में कमाते हैं और शाम को जब ठेकेदार उनको पैसा जाते वक्त देता है, 5:30 बजे जब उनको पैसा मिलता है 280 रुपया, तो उस पैसे से वो अपना घर पहुंचते हुए, जुग्गी में पहुंचते हुए रास्ते में 1 किलो आटा खरीदते हैं, आधा किलो दाल खरीदते हैं, तेल खरीदते हैं, साबुन खरीदते हैं, स्टोव में जलाने के लिए मिट्टी का तेल खरीदते हैं करो से। मुझे समझ में ये नहीं आ रहा कि चलिए बाकी सब लोगों के लिए ठीक है, हमारे आपके जैसे लोगों के लिए ठीक है कि हम लोग 5 दिन 20 दिन 30 दिन भी लॉकडाउन में रह सकते हैं क्योंकि हमारे स्टॉक्स भरे रहते हैं राशन के, लेकिन जो व्यक्ति रोज कमाता है और रोज शाम को खरीदता है सामान, ऐसे करोड़ों लोगों के बारे में क्यों नहीं सोचा गया, ये मुझे अभी तक समझ में नहीं आ रहा। दूसरी बात, मुझे लगता है कि इस देश में जो गरीब है, मजदूर है, किसान है, उसको इंसान ही नहीं समझा गया। और शायद, और ये सिर्फ इसी सरकार की बात नहीं है, ये मैं लगातार देख रहा हूं कि एक गरीब इंसान, वो जो व्यक्ति है गरीब है, जिसके पास पैसा नहीं है, जिसके पास ताकत नहीं है, उस इंसान के साथ ये सौतेला व्यवहार लगातार हो रहा है। और ये लॉकडाउन में जो कुछ हुआ वो एक बहुत बड़ी मिसाल बन गया कि इस देश में, ये देश कंप्लीटली बटा हुआ है दो हिस्सों में, एक हिंदुस्तान वो है जिस हिंदुस्तान में मैं और आप जैसे लोग रहते हैं, और एक हिंदुस्तान वो है जिस हिंदुस्तान में उस इंसान को अगले दिन खाना मिलेगा कि नहीं मिलेगा, उसका चूल्हा जलेगा कि नहीं जलेगा, उससे नहीं पता। और सरकार का क्या काम होता है, सरकारों का काम होता है, स्टेट का क्या काम होता है, स्टेट का काम होता है वेलफेयर, पब्लिक वेलफेयर। और जब सरकारें उसमें नाकाम रहती हैं तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा एक सोचने वाला सवाल है कि सरकारें कब संवेदनशील होंगी, कब सेंसिटिव बनेंगी।
Absolutely. It's been 1 year since the lockdown, 1 year since the migrant exodus, the crisis that we saw unfolding in the months of February, which is still unfolding as of now. People are coming back. Vinod Kapri has come up with a brilliant documentary, 1-2-3-2 Kilometers, which is out on Hotstar. And all of those who are still trying to understand how the crisis unfolded, why people moved out, and what prompted them to leave their homes, should go and watch the documentary. Mr. Kapri, thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for talking about the crisis and how I suppose all of us can come together and realize that this country is more divided than it was a couple of years back.
Thank you.
We can do to make it better.
Thank you, Shweta. Aur aap bhi zarur dekhiyega.
Bilkul, bilkul. Sir, main dekh chuki hu, sir. Maine shuru kar di hai. Puri zarur karungi aaj. Apna samay dene ke liye dhanyawad, sir.